In this lesson, we will finally connect the dots between the concepts we've been working on, like header and menu web blocks, and CSS, and how these are applied to each new page you create in your application. What we'll be focusing on are actually themes in your application. So let me go ahead and select here the customer support theme. And you'll notice that a theme has a bunch of properties here on this properties pane. I will not go and drill down on each one of these properties, but there are a couple of them that I want to focus now. The first one is actually the base theme. So a theme is a central place where you define the look and feel of your application, ensuring consistency in every screen you create. And the base theme allows you to inherit some of these properties that provide you this look and feel and this consistency in your application. In this case, our base theme is the Chicago theme. And we've seen this before when we discussed the style sheet editing in your application. Let me go ahead and show you here on the style sheet editor that remember that we have the theme tab here. The second one, this is the customer support. This is where we put our most generic style definitions for our application that are going to be used throughout our application. And we also said that these are an add-on to the ones that come from this third tab. In this case, this is the Chicago theme. So this is the base theme. Okay, so this is one of the properties that we inherit when we select the base theme. Another property that we inherit, and I want to talk about now, is this layout web block. This layout web block is a web block that is automatically added every time you create a new screen. So for instance, let me go here into the widget tree. You'll notice, and we've seen this before as well, that the basic element that defines your screen is actually a web block. Look here, layout Chicago. This is the value that was on that property. And this web block has a bunch of placeholders. Basically, they define the structure of your application. And if you'll notice, we have here the header, the menu, and the footer placeholders. And look now, if I expand these placeholders, you'll notice that inside these placeholders, we have the common header web block, the menu web block, and the footer web block. And these web blocks are actually also present on the theme property. So let me close here the widget tree and show you that. Those three web blocks are set here. Look, header, menu, and footer. And actually, these web blocks come from the common webflow. So if we go here and expand the webflow, there you have footer, header, and menu. So these web blocks are added to those placeholders every time you create a new screen. So when you create a new screen, the theme will tell you which layout is going to be used to create that screen, and what web blocks will be placed inside the header, the menu, and the footer placeholder.